So after a long wait and a lot of hype, Khan was finally released to us in OB69. His release unfortunately did not generate enough excitement to match all of the hype that was built up around it. The reason for this? Well, Khan is pretty underpowered, and frankly, when characters release underpowered, they are quickly cast to the side and forgotten about. It's not like with some character releases where they release really strong, and you see people talking about them and insta-locking them for quite a while. I remember when Maeve released, everyone talked about Maeve, and people insta-locked her for well over a week, and all Maeve got to hype herself up was a piece of art and a teaser. Khan was hyped up a ton, and even got a lore cinematic centered around him, being this hulking badass of House Iko who was on his way to take on a god. Even when faced with the god Genos, he stood tall, staring him dead in the face, not looking intimidated in the slightest. That image, that persona, it just doesn't transfer into the game at all. Khan doesn't feel strong. He feels weak in almost every area. When the data mining came out for him, he looked like this devastating bruiser that could be very aggressive when played correctly, but in the actual game, he ended up being a support tank. Basically another Torvald, but for deathball comps. Like Torvald, he's also an off-tank. Now, while being a supportive off-tank isn't a bad thing, it is Hi-Rez's design choice, and that's fine. It is a bad thing to be a really weak one. Khan is weak in almost every aspect. Only two things about him are powerful, and one isn't even in his base kit. The first would be his ult. It's like a Makoa hook buffed up to the max. Its auto lock-on has really good range and has multiple uses. You can either grab somebody and just hold them there for 5 seconds while your team kills them, or you can throw them into some hazard or off the map. I personally think holding them there is the better option most of the time, because on some maps you can throw them into the skybox, and they'll be able to bounce off the skybox and use the momentum from that, plus their movement ability, to get back onto the map. Then there's his talent, Firing Line. This gives you and your allies 20% more damage and CC immunity for 4 seconds. Since his ult can only be used every so often, this talent is basically where all of his power comes from, and his other 3 talents cannot compete with it. The amount of things you can stop and cleanse off with it is incredible. A Nar ult? Blocked completely. Makoa hook on an ally? Cleanse it right off of them. You can even do things like use the damage immunity from the Yell to run up and block a BK ult and have the CC immunity stop you from getting stunned, completely nullifying his ult. Even this talent has a downside though. The range on the Yell is low and your teammates have to be close in order for you to save them from CC. So for the most part, Khan's only reaching his full potential in deathball comps or in coordinated environments, like in parties or in scrims or tournaments. His power is completely centered around good team play and nothing else. Paladins is a team game though, so that isn't technically a bad thing, but let's face it, most of the player base isn't going to be playing in scrims. They're going to be playing in public games. Public games often don't have the level of coordination required to get value out of Khan to make him worth picking. I'm going to be completely honest here. If I'm playing competitive and we need an off tank, I'm taking Ruckus or Barrick over Khan 100%, because they can do way more in a public environment since their kits allow them to do more on their own, while Khan can't really do anything on his own. Let's talk about all of Khan's weaknesses. For starters, his weapon. His DPS is very low. I believe it's lower than Torvald's without taking crits into consideration. It also has low ammo and very severe damage falloff. Now there is his Storm of Bullets talent that does make his gun feel better, however it doesn't fix the damage falloff problem, and picking it makes you lose firing line, which is basically the entire reason you're gonna pick Khan, because again, if you want an off tank with good weapons, you'd be way better off with Ruckus or Barrick. His abilities are also very slow and clunky. While I expect some clunkiness from a big bulky tank, I don't expect the abilities to get you killed so easily. Commander's Grab is a slow leap forward that will pull an enemy up into the air and throw them behind you when you make contact with them. This ability leaves you standing there with no protection, at the mercy of your enemies until the animation is done. You're forced to use this ability in the ideal situation to keep yourself from dying because of it. The problem is, the ideal situation doesn't come often. You mainly want to use this ability to grab tanks through barriers and cancel them, or grab Androxus through his reversal or something like that. It's also good for canceling other enemy abilities or ultimates too, or even stopping someone from retreating. The ability is also very buggy. Often you can miss it and it'll still do the animation as if you landed it, so you'll still end up dying because of it. There are also other bugs with it, but that's the big one I've noticed. The power and potential for the ability is there, but it often comes at the cost of your life. There's also his barrier. For a 6,000 HP barrier, it gets melted pretty quickly. But that's not my biggest problem with it. My problem with it is there's a pretty big delay between using an ability and putting it up. Sometimes I sit there spamming the button for a full second and it doesn't go up and I die. This, again, isn't really the kind of clunkiness I expect from even a tank. Terminus's Power Siphon works in a similar way to Khan's Bulwark, since it can be put up and down at will and doesn't feel anywhere near as clunky. Khan also just gets melted pretty fast in general. He only has 4,000 base health and his hitbox is pretty big. Thankfully, his crit hitbox is tiny though. Now, I think if they fixed his grab and his bulwark, then he wouldn't get melted, so I wouldn't say his hitbox and health is the problem. He has a lot of potential survivability. He can heal himself and block some heavy damage with his yell. Like, if timed right, he can block two rockets from Vic's ult with one yell. So again, if they fixed his abilities, he probably wouldn't feel so squishy. Now, how can they fix these problems? Well, for his weapon, there are multiple things that could be done. I'd recommend both increasing its damage and reducing its damage falloff. He is an off-tank, and off-tanks really should be able to put out a good amount of damage. They could also increase the ammo, but I don't think that's needed if they do those two things. As for his abilities, well, for Commander's Grab, 1. I recommend fixing the bugs, and 2. I recommend speeding this ability up. Make the grab and throw happen faster. The dash itself, I think, is probably fine. As for his Bulwark, remove the delay. It'll increase his survivability and make him flow better. Then there's his talents. I'm gonna be honest, I don't know how they can make these three compete with the CC immunity and damage buff from Firing Line. I have no idea. If I had to think of a way, I'd honestly take the CC immunity from Firing Line and make it part of his base kit, then make Firing Line have the bonus damage and maybe increase the distance of the yell. Then I think talent choice would come down to Firing Line or Storm of Bullets, since Storm of Bullets would have the weapon buff backing it up. But even then, I feel like it probably would still be Firing Line. The other talents would have to be buffed up. Like, the barrier talent could make Khan's barrier omnidirectional. It adds something unique and messes with the mechanic of the barrier. As for Vortex Grip, well, the buffs to his grab would make this better, but there is resilience in the game, so it'd still be pretty useless when that's bought. The only thing I can think of is make it reduce the cooldown of the grab as well, so even though the stun can be made useless through resilience, you'll at least be able to use the grab more often. Outside of all that, I don't think Khan needs anything else. He has a pretty solid deck of cards, and his yell is already pretty good since it gives him damage immunity and his team a heal. I don't expect them to go and do everything I mentioned, but I do hope that we'll see some big buffs to Khan in OB70. Because it would kind of suck to release him into competitive the way he is. And remember, new characters are not released into competitive right away, it takes one update, and that's why he won't be in comp until OB70. With the way Khan is right now, I'd barely put him over Ashe, and that's only if the enemy team has a good amount of CC. Again, in a coordinated environment, he can get some good value, but that level of coordination in public games is rare. Khan should feel powerful in public games too, and that power should only be added onto by coordination, not brought into existence by coordination. Anyway, that's my thoughts on Khan. What are your guys' thoughts? Do you think he needs to be buffed? If so, what would you do to him? Or do you think he's fine where he is, or even too good? Let me know in the comments below. And that's pretty much it, guys. I want to thank you all for watching. I very much appreciate it, and I'm going to see you guys later. Bye!